My first set of guests on the show, Dotun, are going to be at ease with us on sports tonight. Dotun, good to have you back with us this Tuesday.
Good evening, Toy.
Yeah.
You know, I do say it very well that I always feel happy sitting here talking sports. That is what we love doing, and we always like to tell people out there that you just need to stay glued to your TV for you to enjoy the best side of sporting activities and sporting news.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And of course, to my far right, Yemi Adebayo is also with us on the show tonight. Yemi, good to have you with us on Sports Tonight this Tuesday.
Always a pleasure to me.
All right, let me give you an idea of what we'll be doing on the show. In the next couple of minutes, we'll focus on some issues. Of course, the fallout of the just concluded 2017 Africa Cup of Nations. The tournament has started, it has ended. 16 teams started the journey, but only one will go home with the trophy. And the one that goes home with the trophy usually gets all the limelight. So we'll talk about the Cameroonians. They are back home on the show. We will also be talking about our brothers, our neighbors, the Black Stars of Ghana. Another disappointing tournament by their own standards. And this time, we'll be talking about their coach who has called time on his career as the coach of the Black Stars. The Israeli, Avram Grant, is no longer going to be in charge of the Black Stars. We'll talk about it as well on the program tonight. We will also be telling you a lot about domestic football. Today, the Nigeria Football Federation Executive Committee had their board meeting in Abuja. They came up with a lot of very interesting recommendations. We'll talk about those recommendations on the program tonight, the impact that we expect that this would have on our football going forward, and of course, the Super Eagles of Nigeria. We will also be talking about match day 7. 6 games will be played between Wednesday and Thursday in the Nigeria Professional Football League. We'll talk about it and we will also encourage you to talk to us about some of those games as well. Let's make this very interactive on the show. Our friends, the league bloggers, have come up with their nominations for outstanding coaches, outstanding players. So we'll take a look at it as well on the program tonight. We will also be talking about our clubs. Remember, Yemi, on the show yesterday, we highlighted the fact that our 4 teams on the continent, guys, need to pull their weight. In the league, the best placed team out of the 4 going to represent us on the continent is Rivers United, and they are 7th on the log.
Now 8th on the log.
Okay, all right. So, and then you look at Rangers down. You look at Wiki, then Ifeanyi Uba, they are in the second half of the log.
Yes, past we've always complained about our clubs not having anything to do when they have competitions.
Before they start their competitions, now they play about 6 games.
You know they are active. And you expect them to take full advantage of the opportunity.
So you can imagine what would have happened if they were not active.
Of course, if at all they are not active, we should be expecting that as soon as the tournament actually started, we should be expecting 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, like we normally see.
The 4 out of, I beg your pardon, out of 4 representatives, first round,
3 out of the tournament.
But we hope that this doesn't happen this time.
Yeah.
But we are hoping. Mm. But if you look at what we are seeing in the Nigerian Professional Football League, like you said the other time, that the top rated team among the 4 representatives of Nigerian clubs in the African organized tournament, football tournament, you see definitely that the best is Rivers United, and they are placed 8 on the league log. And if you now look out, look at others, like Rangers United, the eventual winner of Nigerian Professional Football League last season, actually 16th on the league, which is not good for champion. So going into this particular CAF Champions League, if you look at it very well, you definitely not fancy their chance against a team like Mali, Bamako of Mali. Yes, Bamako of Mali, that knows how to play CAF tournament.
Okay, Dotun. While we'll take a look at what's going on in Cameroon, the fans coming out in large numbers, did you expect that the Nations Cup was going to go the way it went in Gabon?
Of course, I never expected such a thing. If you can remember, some times ago when we had a discussion like this before doing the first round of the tournament, I did say that Congo DR will emerge as the champion of
you
the
were
tournament.
Congo DR.
Of course, because I look at the ability of the team, how they've been playing in the past tournaments, and even if you look at it, They have a very good team. They are cohesive. They spring passes together when they are playing, not like other teams in which we see in the African continent, whereby they play more on head than on the ground. But that of DR Congo, they play more on the ground. But for Cameroon, if you even take a vivid look at it, you see that seven among their the listed players that happens to be one best players in the European continent, talking about those in Chaka, Ofor, and West Bromwich Albion, Liverpool Football Club, actually declined the offer of playing for their national team in the African Cup of Nations. If you now look at all these fantastic players, about seven of them that did say that they don't want to be part of the tournament, and the country still went on to win the tournament, despite the fact that no one actually fancied their chances of even actually qualifying out of the group stage in which they are, because they missed out on the previous African Cup of Nations. But they still went on to win the tournament on a very good and wonderful start.
Okay, Yemi, let me bring you into all of this. And on a rounded, when they were leaving, I think they had their camp somewhere in the Middle East before they hit Gabon. Yes. On a rounded when they were leaving, but look at the story. Look at the reception.
That's why you love football. That's why you love football, because of stories like this. And we're talking about a lot of things. Hugo Bruce, the coach, a lot of us were saying that he's probably handling the poison chalice. But he found a way.
You know, they gave him a mandate. And we felt that was a very good way of telling him that, look, get ready, you're going to be fired. When they give you a mandate
like that
to go and win the tournament, and you know,
anything short of the title, you are out of the
job. And shortly after that, players started pulling out of it. Like I said, this is why you love football. A lot of good stories. You now start having players like Basogog, players that probably without this tournament,
new stars,
unearthing new stars. And they're not a force to reckon with.
Of course.
They carry the title African champions. It's a good story. And, you know, for all of these reasons, that's why you understand why football is the number one sport all over. Surprises happen. In fact, surprises is the nature of football. And this is what the tournament has shown us. For all of us on this side, and people on the streets, nobody. I'm yet to see someone who will be bold and say, I told him before the tournament
that Cameroon will win.
We didn't see it coming.
Everyone. But these guys are now superstars.
Of course.
The surprise element is gone.
Of course.
That gives them a different challenge now.
Of course.
Because when before, nobody knew Basogong, nobody knew those guys. For them to catch everybody by surprise.
Of course.
Now we all know them.
That they are champions.
It's a different challenge altogether. As Yemi would say, if you jump up, you come down.
Of course.
The law of gravity will work on you.
Yes.
But if you climb up, then you can stay up.
Of course.
So now, is this a jump or a climb, Yemi? And
it's a jump. It's not just a jump. It's a leap. But then maybe they can put some springs in between to ensure that they don't come crashing down. Remember Nigeria won in 2013, next edition.
We didn't go.
We were not ready. We were not ready. We had a coach, got the tactics right, and luck. We won.
With next 17 edition, debutants.
Yes. Next edition, we didn't qualify.
Yeah.
And next two editions.
Thank you. Next two editions, we didn't qualify. So, in as much as we all love victories,
of course,
sometimes when the structure is not in place, where some things are not put right, when you stumble on success, the backlash is always that you're not able to sustain the momentum. And that's what I think is going to happen to Cameroon. Basogog is going to be a marked man. Ondoa, a lot of people start studying his weaknesses, in goal.
The defenders, the midfielder. Everybody will now start to understand that this is how they play.
This is their weakness. And the key,
now they have to break people down. They were difficult to break down.
Yes.
Now they have to break people down, of course.
The key thing that made them go this far was the element of surprise. It's not there anymore. Now they have to show that we can throw a punch and we can also take a punch.
Yeah.
They did that in the final. They went down, they came back. And they have to, at least, for instance, to get that World Cup ticket, they have to produce that. Now they already have a disadvantage. They're trailing Nigeria by 4 points. They have to show that, look, we don't have a soft chin. We can throw punches. We can receive them. And at the end of the bout, we're still going to be on our feet. Mm. A lot of Nigerians will not want to hear that because I'm not praying that they will be on their feet after the bout.
No one will pray for that.
But let's quickly move on. And while we celebrate these Cameroonians for what they've been able to achieve, no matter what, whether it was a jump or whether it was a leap or it was a climb, whatever it was, we commend them for what they were able to do in these 3 weeks of the AFCON. Let's quickly go across the borders and talk about our neighbors, Ghana. Dotun Abraham Grant has called time. It was a turbulent 2 years for him as coach of Ghana. Had a running battle with a lot of the officials, and it was a matter of time. We all knew that they were not going to renew his contract. Abraham Grant is gone now. Ghana will begin a search for a new coach. They're trailing Egypt in their World Cup group by five points. It doesn't look good at all for the Black Stars.
It doesn't look good for the Black Stars, like you say, but if you take a vivid look at it, you definitely agree with me to a particular extent that the Ghanaian national team, actually talking about the FE, they often know how to source for good coaches. If you look back at what are the coaches we've been seeing are coaching the Ghanaian national team in the last 6 to 8 years.
They've got a couple of good coaches.
They often get good coaches. So for Abraham Grant to come on board to actually work for them within the period of 2 years and taking them to the semi-finals of African Cup of Nations twice, it was not just
one time in the final.
Once in the final, was defeated via penalty against the eventual winner, and at the semi-final, and now emerges fourth best in the tournament.